your take on Michael Rapaport the other day was maybe the greatest of all time. The views on that were endless. Where is that case at? Is it all done now? Is there still more?
No, I think it's still technically going. But like he's lost, like he lost like the defamation portion, which is the big thing. I think there's some other shit that's like back pay and things of that nature that are still open. We were kind of told, like, I remember the judge being like, don't, you know, or the lawyer saying, don't be an asshole about this because it's still open and the judge might look, you know, frown upon it. So I don't know. It's still open, but it's over. In essence. So
do you know how hard it is to prove defamation for people that work in the media like that? Like, just the standard of proving that you're not just talking shit is so high. You're never going to get that ever.
And the fact that he even went down that road, I mean, you just can't. You cannot lawyer up.
Yes.
If you call yourself the biggest shit talker, ball buster, tough guy in the game, you just can't do it.
Yeah.
What are the chances Michael Rapaport has ever been in a real fight?
Probably none. But here's the thing. He's been on the show before. I interviewed him, and in real life, because you've probably met him as well, obviously.
Yeah, I mean, we worked together. We were actually cool.
Yes.
Until that night, he started talking shit about our fans. I defended our fans, and he went fucking nuclear. Went like right to like personal shit talking, and I was like, oh, okay, well, like, now, you know, the bridge is burned, like, fuck you forever. So you know, that, I mean, and then to expose his own, you know, private DMs with Durant, like, the fuck out of here, man.
I liked Durant's apology, though. Durant's apology was, I'm sorry people saw that. It wasn't that I said I'm just sorry people saw that.
Because it's interesting for me because, again, I met him in real life. You know, he seemed nice at the time. But when you are trying to build yourself to be this persona, right, of the biggest shit talker of all time, and then you actually achieve it, the one thing, like you were saying, you can't do is go back on and start suing for defamation and exposing DMs and all this other shit. Like,
can't do
That's punk bullshit. He got too into the Trump shit, too.
If he
had just done one of those a week, that would have been fine. It would have been entertaining still, but he did it every fucking day. Man.
So many people went down that road. So many people fell into that trap where it was like easy views or, you know, attention like that. And just because, you know, you're getting views and attention doesn't mean it's good or quality or something that's like good for your career. I mean, he fell into that trap, and I wouldn't even call him, you know, I don't think he achieved it. I don't ever think he was like that clever or funny. It was always, it was always like, you know, lazy bullshit. Like, you know, you suck cock. It was like, okay, man. Like,